On December 21st, 2017, I was a high school student in Ohio. I bought this book, The C Programming Language, from Amazon, and there begins my coding journey. When I was in high school, I was just a normal teenager kid who likes stand-up comedy, hip-hops, and anime.
What do you want, a fortune cookie? Like, what?
I looked up to Eminem and thinking I'd be the next rap god during a technology art class where I basically used Photoshop to draw a sinking Titanic. Since I finished a project pretty early, I used the remaining time to draw Rose's naked body. Yeah, I was an idiot. Then I had a revelation. I want to code. It doesn't really make a lot of sense, I know. But seriously, I don't recall exactly how the idea of coding came to me. But all I remember is that I bought this book after class and then received it at the end of that day, because I used to have Amazon Prime. Not anymore, because college makes me poor. On the first night, I spent 3 hours watching YouTube videos for choosing which one is the best IDE, and another 3 hours to choose whether to use Mono Kai or OneDark. Then I started studying. I spent a whole day to go over variables, data types, arrays, functions, loops, and conditionals. Then I typed my first line of code, printf 1 plus 1. When the two appears on the console, I felt like I'm going to be next Jeff Dean, and Facebook would be under my control in no time, until I encountered the infamous pointer, NSOTOTO, segmentation fault. Then I gave up. Yeah, that fast. And then the book only serves as my AP Calculus scratchbook. Now, let's fast forward a year to college. I was not admitted to computer science in the University of Waterloo at first. Instead, I got in math and business administration. In Waterloo, every math kid needs to take at least 2 CS courses. I took CS 135, Design Functional Programs, and CS 136, Elementary Algorithm Design and Data Abstraction. CS 135 was taught in Racket, a functional and basically useless language. But due to its simple syntax, it forces you to focus on the logic, program, math, and not the language itself. Thanks to this course, I also got very comfortable with recursion. CS 136 was about C, memory management, and intro to some basic data structures like array. Things get difficult for me when I start looking for my first co-op job. CS people usually get a lot more interviews, and then they're usually paid so much higher than other people. So I started to want to transfer to CS. For my second year, I took CS 245, which is logic and computation. I learned propositional logic, structural deduction, Turing machine, and Halting problem. It's a boring course and not really useful. Math 239, intro to combinatorics and optimization. The first part of the course, combinatorics, completely fucked me. It's about combinatorial analysis, generating series, recurrence relations, binary strings, and plane trees. I did terrible on this course. It was my lowest math grade ever. Fortunately, my mom doesn't receive my report cards anymore, but now it's on YouTube and she can see it. Whatever. I mean, look at these. It's so hard and scary. I still don't understand. This course is definitely not intro to combinatorics and optimization. It's intro to my PTSD. CS 246. Object-oriented programming. It was taught in C++. This course was immensely useful. In this course, I learned Linux, Bash, classes, functions, makefiles, encapsulation, inheritance, polymorphism, and just to name a few. Before I took this course, I applied to transfer to CS, but I failed, which I don't understand why, since my grades are really good. CS 246 was my last chance, because it's the last CS major course that a non-CS person can take. If I do well, I will get in. If I do bad or not good enough, I'm stuck in math and business. Fortunately, I did pretty well in the end. I did very well in the midterm, got a 92.6 highest in the class, while the mean and median is 58.8 and 62.8. The final was very easy since COVID just hit, and in the end, I got a 94 in the course. And a week later, I'm a CS boy. In my third and fourth year, I took more data structure and algorithm courses, like CS 240 and CS 341, where I learned HashMap, SkipList, TryBST, compression, sorting, graph algorithms, and dynamic programming. I also took a database course, where I learned SQL, relational calculus, and theoretical inner workings of database. And one of the most brain-wracking things a human being can ever do, writing SQL in C. I had a lot of fun debugging the program. Fuck CS SQL. CS 251, Computer Organization and Design. This course talks about CPU instructions, pipelining, ALU, SRAM, DRAM, multi-cycle data path. I learned a lot, but I forgot them all. CS 350, Operating System, one of the most hardcore CS courses. I learned about locks, semaphore, thread, processes, and things like that. The entire course was taught in C. I get to do a lot of C programming. So after the course, I leveled up my C skill by quite a bit. But as you probably noticed, most of what I learned in school is not so directly applicable to industry. A job interview doesn't test if you know how to prove a formula is sound and complete. It tests LeetCode type of questions. And in my school, there's no application development courses where you can learn HTML, CSS, and JavaScript to build a full web app or a mobile app using Kotlin or Swift. So it's completely on my own. During my free time, I'll grind LeetCode, which I absolutely hate. I hate it. I'll also learn all those technologies like HTML, CSS, TypeScript, Angular, Spring Boot, things like that, and Docker. And when I'm tired and feeling lazy, which is pretty much all the time, I'll watch stand-up comedy, listen to hip-hops, and watch anime.
What you doing, boy?
I also learned a lot from my personal projects and internship. I really got into Angular since all of those companies that are internet use Angular. I also built a personal portfolio, but it's not there anymore because I used a domain name to host my Shopify application projects, and I'm too lazy to change it back. It doesn't look so nice anyway. And boy, it's 2021. How can anybody go without machine learning? If you don't know machine learning, you can't call yourself a software engineer. So I registered this machine learning course on Coursera that teaches fundamentals of machine learning. This is my third time taking it, and I am very hopeful that I can finish week 3 and finally start week 4 this time. This video is so long, there must be a lot of editing to do. I'm so tired. I haven't watched this week's One Piece on Boruto yet. What, you are not? You're not tired? Damn, you have so much energy. Then what about like my video and subscribe to my channel? Okay, gotta go. Bye.